My dear students, children, I welcome you again to the online class of computers. Now children, as we have already done with the syllabus, so it's time to do the revision. First of all, you all must have know that what is the syllabus of your class. Now see children, this is the syllabus for your computer exam. Chapter 1, Computer, a Machine. Chapter 2, Uses of Computer. Chapter 3, Parts of Computer. These three lessons we have already done will come in your exam. Okay children, now you have to go through the videos and you have to learn all the question answers which I have given you to do. Now children, one more important thing is that marks will be awarded for each assignment and homework. Means the assignments, the homework which we are giving to you, that is also the marks for that. Okay, means we will award you marks. Like 20 assignments are there, so that we give you marks for that. Okay children, so now children, you have to be very careful while doing your homework and you have to send me all the homework. Okay, those who have not sent the homework, they also have to send me all the assignments of theirs. Okay children, so these are the important notes which I want to share with you. So now children, let us get with the revision of your syllabus. Okay children, some questions from chapter number 1. You have to do these questions in your notebook. Here, I'll tell you the answers. We'll discuss the answers orally, but you have to write down the answers in your notebook. Okay? Now, from chapter number 1. What is the first question here? Two types of object. Now, children, tell me, what are the two types of objects that are found in our nature? Yes, children. They are natural objects and man-made objects. Very good. Natural objects are found in nature, like flowers, fountain, sun. These all are what? Natural objects. They all are made by God. We do not make them. We cannot make them. Okay? It is. They are not made by humans. They are made by what? God. Okay? Now, the next type of object is man-made object. Now, what are man-made objects? The objects which are made by man, which are made by us. Okay children, like fan, television, mobile phones, these are what? Man-made objects. Okay, so you have to write down the name of the two types of object in your notebook. You have to note down the question like this and then A part and then B part. Okay, now come to the next question. Write down the type of the following. The first one is bicycle. Now children, bicycle is what? Yes, it is a man-made object. So you will write down man-made here. Okay. Next comes tree. Tree is what? Tree is a natural object. So what you will write down? You will write down natural object here. Okay. Come to the next C part. Fan. What children? It is a kind of a man-made object. It is man-made object. So you will write down man-made here. Okay. Now come to the D part, flower. Flower is what? It is a natural object. Natural object. Okay children. So this is how you have to note down the question in your notebook and you have to write down the answer in front of them. Okay. So this is a revision of your. Okay. The third question. Machine makes our work dash. Machine makes our work easy. So write down easy here. E-A-S-Y. Write down the spelling of easy. Written? Okay. Now come to the next question. Question number 4. Machine saves our dash. Machine saves our time. So write down time here. T-I-M-E. Time. Okay children? Now come to the fifth part. Computer is an dash machine or device. Computer is an electronic device. What is the spelling of electronic? electro, electro, nic, 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 electronic. So computer is an electronic device. So write down electronic here. Okay, now come to the next. Dash computer can be kept on a desk or table. Now children, there are two types of computer we are studying in your book. They are and laptop computer. So the computer which on a table or a desk are known as what? Desk computer. So write down desktop here. D E S desk T O B top desktop. Okay. Now come to the seventh question. Dash computer can be carried anywhere. Now children, desktop computers are kept in table, but the computer which can be carried from one place to another or anywhere, they are called laptop. So write down L A P lap T O P top laptop. You have to write. So here is your question number 8. Write I for machines found inside and O for the machines found outside the house. Now children, here I have given you some machines. You have to find out, you have to write down that whether these machines are found inside or outside the house. Okay, so the first one is television. Television is found where? Outside or inside the house? Yes children, it is found inside. Who will write down I? I means inside. I for inside. Okay, next is bus. What you write here? Where a bus is found? Inside or outside the house? Yes children, it is found outside the house. So you will write down capital O here. O for outside. Okay, come to the next question. Next part, juicer. Juicer is found where? Yes, it is found in the kitchen inside the house. So write down I. I means inside. Next is van. Van is found outside the house. So you will write down O here. Okay. Now children, come to the next question. Question number 9. Name the following. A part, brain of computer. Now children, tell me which part of a computer is known as brain of computer? Yes, CPU. So you will write down what? CPU in capital letter. C, P and then U. Come to the B part. Displays the result. Now children, which part of a computer displays the result? Yes, monitor. So you will write down monitor here. The spelling of a monitor is M-O-N-I. Monitor. Monitor. Okay children? So write down monitor here. Okay. So children, now let's start with the revision of chapter number 2. Okay. The first one is uses of computer. Here I have written some uses of computer. Means what the things a computer can do. Okay. So say children, the first use of a computer is listening to music. We can listen to music on a computer. Okay. Next one is typing letters. We can type letters, numbers, documents on a computer. Next is solving sum. Computer can be used for solving sums, mathematical addition and subtractions. Okay. Now D part D is drawing picture. We can draw pictures on a computer. Okay. Next is playing games. You can play games on a computer also. Okay children. Next one is sending emails. We send messages to our friends through email. Okay. So a computer can be used for these purposes. So now children, you will write down the heading like this and you will write down the answers like this. And you have to learn this also. Okay. Because any question can come in your half yearly exam regarding this. So the next question is places where computer is. When you have to write down the name of the places where computer is used. Here I have written only 4. Okay, this much only you have to write down in your notebook. So in schools, computer are used in schools. For what? For teaching subjects. For teaching various subjects. We can teach you various subjects using a computer. Okay children, next at railway station. A computer can be used where? At railway station. And railway station, for what purpose we use computer at railway station? For booking tickets. Booking what? We can book tickets on a computer at railway stations. Okay, come to the next part. In banks, a computer is used in banks for what? For depositing, okay, for keeping and withdrawing, means for taking the money. Okay, come to the next. Hospitals, a computer is used in hospitals for what? It is used for what purpose? It is used, it is used keeping records of patients. The patients, those who were there, the computer is used for keeping the records of them. Okay, so we use a computer in hospital for keeping records of what? Of whom? Of patients. Okay children, so places where computer is used, so you have to write down this, and you have to write down this much only. Okay, no need to write down this. If you want to write, then you can write, but if you don't want to, then you can write down only this much. This is only for the explanation that for what purpose computer is used in these places. Okay, so it's up to you. If you want to, you can write down this much only, and you can write down their purposes only. Okay, it is up to you. Now here comes the third question. Identify the types of the games given below. Now children, in this chapter number 2, we have studied about the indoor games and outdoor games. Okay, I've already explained. Indoor games can be played inside the house, and outdoor games can be played outside the house in a field. Here what you have to do, you have to find out that whether these games are played inside or outside the house, means whether they are outdoor games or indoor games. Okay, so the first is football. So children, football is what type of a game? Indoor game or outdoor game? It is an outdoor game. Why? Played on the field outside the house. Okay children, so write down outdoor game. What you will write? OUT, out, DOOR, door, game, outdoor game. Okay, chess is a what kind of a game? Yes children, it is an indoor game, because we can play it inside the house. So you will write down indoor game. Okay, next is carom is what? Yes, carom is a what kind of a game? It is played inside the house, so it is also indoor game. So you will write down indoor, indoor, game, game. And for outdoor, out, door, outdoor, game, outdoor game. Now children, one more important thing you have that. Don't play too many computers. Please don't play too many games on computer. Why? Because it can harm your eyes. If you will play for so long on a computer, it can harm your eyes. It can affect your eyes. Okay? So be careful while playing on a computer. Now children, you have to note this much only till here. Okay? In your notebook. No need to note down like this. This is only the thing which I want to tell you. So children, this is enough for today. In this video, we have done the revision of chapter 1 and chapter 2. What you have to do, the questions which I have given you today, you have to do them in a notebook, and you have to write down answers of there. You have to send me the mail. And again, I'm reminding you that you have to complete all your assignments, because we will give you marks for that. Okay children, at first I have given you the syllabus. Okay children, so write down these questions in your notebook and write down their answers also. Okay children, I just hope that you all will revise your syllabus, and you will study at your home. Okay, in first term you have done well, but still I want you to score good marks in half yearly exams. Okay children, these marks will include in your report card also. So prepare prepare yourself for getting good marks. I'll be meeting soon you in the next video. Till then, stay safe and stay home.